realize we got a $31 trillion debt. It's not going away. We spend more than we take in every year, and you can't solve all that just by raising taxes, which is, you know, a lot of what the president proposed last night. You figure out how do we strengthen these programs. And that doesn't mean you have to cut things, but there are a lot of younger Americans today who understand that if something isn't done, they're not, Social Security is going to be around for them. I mean, if you're talking about huge cuts in this program not too far down the road when it goes bankrupt, if we don't do some things to make it stronger and make it viable, not just for current generations, but also for future generations of Americans. And there are things that are out there. There's a proposal out there right now, which is bipartisan. Bill Cassidy, he's got half a dozen Republicans, half a dozen Democrats on Social Security reform. And it does it in a way that strengthens the program, avoids those steep cuts that would occur in the future. And I think it's, you know, that's the kind of thing we ought to be talking about, because both sides have to agree. We can't sustain this. You can't have $31 trillion in debt and climbing every year. And I think the president, if he wants to, this could be a real legacy issue. He could come to the table, and it's going to take presidential leadership to do something big and consequential like this. And I